Hi. Hi. Hi, Emily. Hi, good to see you.
In your career overall, who do you feel like has been the biggest advocate for you in the industry?
As far as like the doing of the thing. You know, I think there have been many people who have inspired me. I have really only one hero, besides my mother, truly, and that's Ms. Oprah Winfrey. She has been my lifetime hero since I was a kid, and still today, and has been just exceptional as a human being so far. I also have been so inspired, you know, when I was doing The Wiz this past year, getting to stand beside Queen Latifah was pretty intense, because I thought that she, I mean, I think she's amazing. I just wanted to sing the theme song to Living Single, and you and I, like literally the entire time, there we go. Like, I really just wanted to do that the entire time. I think she's phenomenal, what she's been able to do across multiple platforms as an artist, performer, producer, rapper, jazz singer, actor, writer, you know, and the list goes on and on. That's been phenomenal. Viola. I mean, I really have some actors that I just think. Meryl Streep I've watched and been impressed with as well. But in terms of advocates, I'd say that's first.
Hi. Is it right? Your time.
Hi. Good to see you. Beat Boston in that.
Yep. First of all, congratulations. This is your second one in a row of these, I do believe.
Thank you.
And, you know, in such a large ensemble cast that keeps doing so well at this particular award and all others, what is it about the Crazy Eyes character that keeps jumping out at
everyone? You know, I don't think that I am best equipped at answering that question in all sincerity, with, as far as what people are drawn to with her. I know for myself, what I love about her is her authenticity, her honesty, her willingness, despite the hard, the challenge that is love, and it just even necessarily maybe even existing authentically as herself, she still risks it, despite the challenge that it takes to be that much herself. I love that about her. She's entirely, purely herself. And that's what I like about her.
Uzo, congratulations from all the radio guys in the back.
Hi, thank you.
You know, you did it last year. You mentioned that the day you won the SAG Award was the day you gave up acting. And this year, you had some encouraging words for struggling actors still. So this is still very close to your heart, isn't it? The fact that you almost wouldn't be here except for whatever that magical role is. So can you speak to how that still means something to you now?
You know, it means a lot to me now. When I think about it, that day, that time, the day before even, the day that I got this job, that sight is not so, it's still visible in the rearview mirror of my life. I can still see it. You know, it's not so far back, so distant that I can't recall that feeling. I can't remember that day. I can't remember what it felt like to hear repeatedly, no, 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 or to not get that audition. I know that feeling. It resonates throughout my entire being so loudly. I can't ignore it. And I can't feel anything other than grateful for it. And I feel that, you know, it came to my mind for some reason when I was standing up here, wow, I'm here at the SAG-AFTRA Awards, the Screen Actors Guild, and just the other day, I happened to be scrolling through my Facebook, and a young actor had written me about, you know, business and agents, and I just felt like there are so many people who have so much to give to this art form, who have to say, have so much to say that with their art, that I just wanted to acknowledge that because I know the feeling.
Last question.
Brady Within Style.
Hi.
Hi, kind of along those same lines, what was one piece of advice that someone gave you when you first started out that helped you get to where you are today?
I think the greatest piece of advice single-handedly that I've ever been given, it came from my mother. My family immigrated here, for those of you who don't know, from Nigeria. My mom has overcome numerous obstacles to make it possible for me to be standing here in this moment with you all. And when I moved to New York to pursue this, she dropped me off at the train station and she turned off the car, so she meant business. And she was like, Ulfa, just work hard. She's like, I don't know what will come from this thing. All I know is that if you go there, you must go and work hard. I've never heard of nothing coming from hard work. And that was the something that stood out. She always said that our entire life, to not just myself, but all my siblings. And for some reason, though, on that day, I really heard her and what she was, you know, really trying to put into me. She said, I've never heard of nothing coming from hard work. I don't know what will come. I don't know when it will come, but I know something will come if you work hard. And I just said, okay, I just need to work hard. That's the best way.